Hello friends, I'm Sudhir and you are enjoying the YouTube channel English Carnival, a journey of learning with joy. Friends, today we are going to explore some important multiple choice questions based on the oldest form of poetry, and that is the ode. But friends, before we proceed, as usual, I request you to subscribe to this channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this channel called English Carnival in coming days. Friends, as far as the ode is concerned, it has maintained its elevated position in the history of literature and it is known to all of us. Friends, as ode is a lyrical stanza written in praise for a person, event or thing. This form of poetry developed in ancient Greece with some specific structure. Friends, later on this form was popularized and adopted in Renaissance and it paved the way to a new set of conventions. So friends, let's move and see the ode in detail with the help of some multiple choice questions and their answers. So friends, let us move and see the first question. We have the first question. In an ancient Greece, odes were designated to be dash. Options are A. A supplement to formal philosophical arguments. B. Read out loud in public settings. C. Carved into a leader's headstone after death. And D. All of the above. Correct answer is B, and it is read out loud in public settings. Second question we have. What is an ode? Options are A. Elaborate poem glorifying or praising an event, individual, idea, emotionally and or intellectually. B. A place of worship. C. Elaborate poem glorifying or praising animals, inanimate objects and emotions. And D. None of these. Correct answer is A, and it is an elaborate poem glorifying or praising an event, individual, idea, emotionally and or intellectually. Question 3 we have. An ode is dash. Options are A. Rhyming. B. Free verse. C. Metered to free verse to prose poem. And D. Never rhymes. Correct answer is C, and it is metered to free verse to prose poem. Question number 4 we have. What is a Horatian ode? Options are A. Geared towards a reading audience. B. Less lofty. C. Intimate and contemplative. And D. All of the above. Correct answer is D, and it is all of the above. Next question, question number 5 we have. There can be an irregular ode. It must indulge but B dash. Options are irregular, B irregular, C over 15 verses, and D contain two or more stanzas. Correct answer is B, and it is an irregular. Question number 6 we have. The opening line of ode sometimes contain dash. Options are A. An apostrophe or appeal. B. Epode. C. Both A and B. And D. Anti-strophe. Correct answer is A, and it is an apostrophe or appeal. Question number 7 we have. The most important feature of an ode is dash. Options are A. It is longer than a lyric. B. Its subject matter is exalted. C. It is in the form of an address. And D. It is serious and dignified poetic composition. Correct answer is C, and it is in the form of an address. Question number 8 we have. A Pindaric ode has three parts. Options are A. Poster, pastel. B. Canon, effective, allonym. C. Strophe, antistrophe, and epode. And D. Acronym, anagram, and ampersand. The correct answer is C, and it is strophe, antistrophe, and epode. Question number 9 we have. If winter comes, can spring be far behind? What is the name of the ode in which this line occurs? Options are A. Ode to duty. B. Ode to autumn. C. Ode to evening. And D. Ode to the west wind. Correct answer is D, and it is Ode to the West Wind by P.B. Shelley. Question number 10 we have. Ode originated in dash. Options are A. Rome, B. England, C. Greek, and D. France. Correct answer is C, and ode originated in Greek or Greece. Question number 11 we have. Which ode is based on dance and movements of dancer? Options are A. Lesbian, B. Horatian, C. Dorian, and D. None of these. Correct answer is C, and it is a Dorian oat. Question number 12 we have. The ancient Greek poet Pindar lived during that century BC. Options are A, 5th, B, 6th, C, 7th, and D, 8th. Correct answer is A, and he lived during 5th century BC. Question number 13 we have. John Keats was one of the most famous masters of Dash. Options are A, Irregular Ode, B, Horatian Ode, C, Pindaric Ode, and D, none of these. Correct answer is B, and it is Horatian Ode. Question number 14 we have. Ellen Tate's Ode to the Confederate Dead is an example of Dash. Options are A, Irregular Ode, B, Horatian Ode, C, Pindaric Ode, and D, none of these. The correct answer is B, and it is Horatian Ode. Question number 15 we have. Irregular Ode is also known as Dash. Options are A, Pindaric Ode, B, Horatian Ode, C, Spenserian Ode, and D, Cowleian Ode. Correct answer is D, and it is also known as Cowleian Ode. Question number 16 we have. The epode Dash. Options are A, serves to conclude the idea of the ode, B, offers a thematic content balance, C, forms a distinct unit within a poem, and D, none of these. Correct answer is A, and it is serves to conclude the idea of the ode. Question number 17 we have. Ode to the West Wind by P.B. Shelley is an example of Dash. Options are A, Pindaric Ode, B, Horatian Ode, C, Irregular Ode, and D, none of these. Correct answer is C, and it is an example of an irregular ode. Question number 18 we have. Ode is much like a or an Dash. Options are A, Epic, B, Ballad, C, Sonnet, D, Elegy. Correct answer is D, and it is an elegy. Question number 19 we have. Which one of the following is not a type of ode? Options are A, Odian, B, Pindaric, C, Horatian, and D, Irregular. Correct answer is A, and it is Odian. Question number 20 we have. Which poetic form comes from the Greek adian, meaning to sing or chant, and belongs to the long and varied tradition of lyric poetry? Options are A, Sonnet, B, Ballad, C, Elegy, D, Ode. Correct answer is D, and of course it is an ode. Question number 21 we have. Ode is reversed by which poet to convey their strongest sentiments? Options are A, Metaphysical Poets, B, Romantic Poets, C, Cavalier Poets, and D, none of these. Correct answer is B, and it is Romantic Poets. Question number 22 we have. Ode on intimations of immortality from recollections of early childhood is the poetic work of Dash. Options are A, Shakespeare, B, John Keats, C, Coleridge, and D, Wordsworth. Correct answer is D, and it is William Wordsworth. Question number 23 we have. Ode on a Grecian Urn is written by Dash. Options are A, Wordsworth, B, John Keats, C, Shakespeare, and D, Shelley. Correct answer is B, and it is John Keats. Question number 24 we have. Dash literary form is first developed by poets writing in ancient Greek. Options are A, Ode, B, Sonnet, C, Elegy, and D, Ballad. Correct answer is A, and it is Ode. Question number 25 we have. A poetic form which is a tribute to its subject, although the subject need not be dead or even sentient, is Dash. Options are A, Elegy, B, Sonnet, C, Ballad, and D, Ode. Correct answer is D, and it is Ode. So friends, all these are the multiple choice questions and their answers based on the oldest form of poetry, and that is the ode. I hope friends you have liked all these multiple choice questions discussed in this video. If you have really liked it, I request you to like it, share it among your friends near and dear ones as well. Friends, if you are a new viewer to this channel, then I request you to subscribe to this channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this particular channel called English Carnival in coming days. So friends, we'll meet soon again with a different video on different piece of literature. Till then friends, just take care of yourself and be happy. Thank you very much.